You know my little dog. I have a little dog named Lola. Well, she's not my dog. She's my daughter's little Frenchie bulldog. And she had an injury to her back where she was paralyzed from the back down. She couldn't walk. And the vet said to put her down, that she would suffer and for us to put her down. We refused to put her down, refused. And the vet said that there was nothing they could do. And we just weren't hearing it, So we took her home, and the vet gave us some medication for her, and she said, "This is the last Hail Mary." And I was like, "What's Hail Mary got to do with this?" I didn't realize that when they say this is the last Hail Mary, it's like this is their last chance. Did you know that?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that. So she wasn't getting any better, and it was on a Sunday, and I just knew, I just knew that we would have to put her down, and I was like, "Okay, God." And then I was like, "Is there a heaven for dogs?" This is when I start thinking about all this. And I think Vicky called me to see how I was doing, and I wasn't doing good at all, And so that's when you came over, Pastor Dave. And I was like, "Oh, Pastor Dave's here," And you came to my house, and you didn't have to come to my house, and I know that, but you showed up, you came, and you prayed over Lola. And the next morning, that very next morning, that little dog got up, her little legs were shaking, and I woke up talking, "Get up, look at Lola." And she was standing, but she was shaking, but she was standing. She couldn't stand at all because she was paralyzed. She was dragging herself. And I was like, "There's a God, Tommy. There's a God. I'm convinced there's a God." So for me, everything that's happened to me, Pastor Dave, has been because of my affiliation with your ministry, see? Everything. I got the cancer, and that's when I went over to Miss Shirley, sent me over there. And then when I went back to Stanford, they don't know why, they don't know what happened, they don't even know where it went. They just said, "It's gone." And I was there with my whole family, and they had no explanation. And I looked at them, I go, I think it's God, maybe." And we left. And then my sciatica, and Tommy was like, "Go ask him to pray over you. He's a healer." I looked at Tommy like, "What have you been smoking? I thought you were clean. What have you been smoking?" Because I was a non-believer. I still didn't believe. Because like I said, for me, you have to show me, And so these things that have happened to me have happened because of your ministry and because of the people there. And I want to tell you something, Pastor Dave. I wholeheartedly now believe that there's God, And God has blessed me in ways that you will never even. I mean, I'm never hungry. I'm never without. I don't make a whole lot of money. I don't have a whole lot of everything, but I have a whole lot of happiness, and I have a whole lot of God, which makes up for everything that I could ever want. And God has been good to me, And my purpose now is to help other people. I'm not. I mean, I don't know too much about the Bible. But I believe that God kept me here for a reason. And that's my whole mission. And if anything, I owe you my life, Pastor Dave. I don't know how, I don't know how you like put up with me. I know I'm a lot. I mean, I know that. And I know I could be a lot. I could be like a real lot. But my life is good today, you know what I mean? And I have everything that I need. And I think about it, all the time, and I think about if Vicky and Kevin weren't there, always to advise me at the right way to do things and not Robin's way, which is usually the wrong way, and I get a lot of advice from you. I get a lot of scoldings too, but I have to learn how to live right by the way God wants you to live. Just because I do help people doesn't mean I know how to live the right way. You know, I bump my head a lot, but it's okay because I get right back up and God shows me the right way to go.
That's awesome.
And that's so that, you know, if anything, it wasn't Downtown Street Team, it was Street Life Ministries.
Oh, that's sweet.
It's the truth.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
For that, Robin.